Synthetic Aperture Radar. In the first part of the lesson, we are going to see what is a radar, that is the core of the system. Radar is the acronym of radio detection and ranging. And is an active remote sensing system. The remote sensing system are systems that observe the Earth or object from a remote. This means that we don't need to touch or to be in contact with the object. And is an active sen remote sensing. This means that radar provide the illumination that you need to do the measure. For instance, photogrammetry is a remote system, but it needs the sun, so it's a passive system because our camera collects the signal, but it needs that the energy is provided by the sun. In this case, the system provides the radiation, the signal that you need to do the measure. The emitter radiation is a microwave region of the electromagnetic spectrum, so it means that the frequency more or less are always in the same range of the GPS, a radio frequency. And the radar measures the travel time and the strength of the return signal. We're going to see better. At first, I have to introduce the geometry, some terms that we use for the radar. We speak about azimuth direction and range direction. The radar is on an antenna or aircraft or now also on drone, but so it's a movement platform, and the direction along the movement of this platform is called azimuth direction. The direction of the along the where the radar sends the pulse, the radiation, is called range. The projection of the range in the ground is called ground range. The area covered by the pulse are called Schwarz area. And this angle between the vertical of the platform to the direction of the emission of the signal, transmission of the signal, is called look angle. Okay, they send pulse with a given length in term of time, so we have different pulse. And okay, so we have azimuth and range direction. These are the most important quantity. The frequency. We have a signal in X band, so with a wavelength of 3 cm, in C band with a wavelength of 6 cm, or L band is the band of the GPS with a wavelength of 24 cm. The most used are the first two. Why they use this very short? We use this very short wavelength because the system work in any weather with any weather condition, and we have to pass the ionosphere. So we have seen when we have talked about the ionosphere for the GPS that okay, we have to be able to go through the ionosphere. Usually the ionosphere is used. The ionosphere layer is used for communication around on the Earth. So now we need a system that is not reflected by the ionosphere, but can go through the ionosphere layer. In fact, if you look at the atmospheric transmission percent, you see that in this for this type of scene, we have a good atmospheric transmission coefficient. So the signal can go through the atmosphere. Okay, we are going to see this later, but the radar is a combination of the movement of the platform with the ground and the signal. We're going to see better later this aspect, but it's important because part of the measure is related to the Doppler effect. So it's important this relative movement between the platform and where is the radar is and the ground. These are information about one of the most important missions in the past, but we are going to see better later. Okay, when a radar signal is sent on the ground, part of the signal is absorbed by the ground, part of the signal is reflected in all the directions, but part of the signal came back to is reflected in the reflected back to the satellite to the radar, and so the radar is able to measure the round trip time of this signal, so to come in and to be reflected back. Okay, but one important thing is that there is an interaction between our signal and the surface that we have. This reflection depends really from the condition of the ground, from the geometry and the physical and chemical property of the ground. So this is in an ideal case, it's reflected with the same angle, but usually we have a diffuse component, so not really like a straight line. And we also have some scattering related to the geometry of the ground. So you see the angles are not equal, but can be different. So the scattering depends on the roughness of the surface, depend on the slope of the surface, by the incident angle, and also depend on the electrical property of the material on the ground. It depends on the temperature, the humidity, and so on, and which type of material that the signal reach. So you can see for a dry soil, we have less backscattering intensity. When you have a fluid soil, you have low scattered radar intensity, and when it's wet, higher backscattering radar intensity. So it's really related to the condition of the ground. You have to see that we are using very short wavelengths because it's 3-6 centimeters, so it's very short, and it's really related to the geometry and to the local property of the ground, because with a very short wavelength I really it's different that I arrive here or here. I can see the difference in the ground because we are using very short wavelengths.
Excuse me.
Yes.
For dry soil, it has a loose backscattering intensity.
Yes, in the intensity less. Yeah, as an example to be, we are going to see better this problem. But an example, it means that it's really depend on the property of the ground.
Why it's different for waste soil and flooded soil? Because flooded is
It depends really from the quantity of the water that you have in the wet. It means that you have a lot of humidity. You say flood is means that it's covered by water. So it's really different the interaction between this radiation with the ground. We are going to see that in the sea we don't have measure, or we have to use a special frequency to perform the measure. So are really example of backscattering. You can found, for instance, tree, and so you have a type of reflection, like a multipath for the GPS. You have different reflection and so on. So just to say, it's a very complicated. We are going to see the interaction between radiation and the sound and the ground. This is you see the back is a very old picture. Is a backscattering coefficient in terms of decibel, in terms of okay, divided by the different type of ground that we can met. For instance, the high backscattering coefficient we find in the industrial zone, when we have a very big building, very regular, with often with a roof that can reflect the signal very well. The less backscattering coefficient are in arid deserting, and when you have a heavy vegetation and so on. We are going to see that this is really important, because we have different results. It depends on where you are. It's a real measure.
The backscattering coefficient depends on the magnitude of the signal, the energy.
Yes, but it's the same. The system uses the same energy. It's a constant quantity. You can have, yes. For my knowledge, it's the same. You have a system made in this way with this wavelength and the same characteristic, more or less. What is changing, we are going to see that it's changed how they can cover a surface, but more or less. And this is the formula to say that here is the power of intercepted by the receiver, the signal that came back to the satellite. If PT is a transmitted signal, and you see that the part that the power that came back to the receiver depend by the wavelength, it depend by the radar scattering cross section, are very electromagnetic quantity and so on. So the distance between satellite and scattering is quite complicated. This techniques was developed by the electronic scientific community. So there is a very heavy electronic part to really understand better in a good way the system. So now we are going to see an important thing about resolution. We can define three times of the resolution, and resolution means that the minimum area that we can observe with this system. And we are going to see the resolution in the three direction. I'm going to see. Sorry. Okay. I don't remember why I put here this. Okay. Because I talk about resolution cell. Okay, before talking about resolution, I'm going to introduce the system. The system can measure the intensity of the back signal and the phase of the reflected signal. So we have a radiometric information and geometric information. Radiometric is related to the intensity and geometric is related to the phase. We're going to see that it's the phase that give us information about the distance between satellite and ground. From radar, what we obtain, we measure round trip time, but what we obtain is images. That can be represented by a complex matrix of echoes, is mean of a reflected signal. And images is a mosaic of pixels, or now we know that what is a digital images, and each pixel give a complex number, and we use complex number to record the two quantities, the intensity and the phase of the measure. With a complex number, we are going to see in form, we can represent these two quantities. So, if you look at this measure, we have the azimuth direction, the direction of the movement, and the range direction. And we can, this relative movement between the satellite and the pulse collected these images. It means that the pulses are sent with a very high frequency, but the satellite is moving in the azimuth direction. But we send the pulse with a very high frequency, so we send the signal and we obtain information about the echo. After we can move and obtain the other. The high difference between these two velocities, the velocity of the pulse and the velocity of the satellite, is the core of these images. Okay? The satellite is like if the satellite is moved after receive the echoes. It's not true, it's still moving. But we have these very high differences in the velocity. So we can really collect this measure because we obtain information for all the points in the range or ground range, and after we can move.
Frequency high frequency means time period very low. So time period very low means, so to complete two cycles, it takes, okay, yeah, I can pass.
Okay. But because we use the signal with 90 megahertz, mm-hmm. But the movement in the azimuth direction is at a frequency, is not okay, more or less it can convert in 1060 hertz, so it's very different. And this different velocity allows us to collect data, this matrix, the two directions. So, the resolution in the slant range. Slant range is meaning the range in this really along the direction of of the signal. So if you have two targets, target one and target two, we want to find as a resolution, and we call this distance resolution, the minimum distance between these two points that we can really observe by the radar. So we can see this in a different way, position, target one and target two are not together, are not confused. So this minimum distance is called resolution in the slant. So we can, there is of course a relationship between the time and the distance. And okay, a time in the distance correspond to a time differences. We put the term 2 because it is is you have to go and come back. Mm-hmm. So it's a double distance. So, which is the if you invert this form, which is the minimal interval of time, is related to the pulse length tau. And this pulse length is related to the length of all the impulse of the pulse. So it's given by this equation. So the resolution is in the range, the length range mean that I am in this direction, this, I emit my radiation, and which is the minimum distance between target one and target two to be really separated in my return back, in my return echoes, okay? And it's really related to the time when I send impulse and I came back, if because it's related really to the dimension of this impulse. Because if you have impulse very low, so you the resolution. Okay, the minimum distance, the resolution increases as a number, so it means that the minimum distance is between point is bigger. So you point really close can be distinguish each other. Okay, resolution in the slant, in the ground slant range, it means that we project the resolution along the slant range on the ground. So you can obtain using the resolution in the range, project this resolution look using the look angle, you obtain this quantity on the ground range. So it's me, for instance, for the S1 was a mission of a European Space Agency and one of the most important in the past, and the ground resolution was about 25 meters. So we can distinguish this is the resolution. It means that our cell in the ground, in the, our images, have this type of resolution. All the point in this direction, inside 25 meter, are in the same pixel, in the same images. So you say it depends on the pulse. So to reduce these values, we have to reduce this, but we need a pulse with sufficient energy to obtain the comeback echo. So we cannot reduce, there are some physical limitation in this parameter, okay? Because we need energy to obtain a comeback signal.
RR in this figure. Which one is RR? Not clear.
RR?
Yeah.
Ah, is the resolution along this part. So it's here. And we project in the ground. The first resolution, this one, okay, you have to see in the slant range. Mm-hmm. So it means that in this picture you have this part.
There's RR.
Yeah. RR. The resolution in the range. The range is the slope line. Okay, so you have a resolution, the minimum distance in this direction, and we project in the horizontal.
That's RGR.
RGR.
It's
horizontal.
Horizontal ground. Okay. Yes.
But from the trigonometry, it's not like it's.
Yes.
Sanitizing
is too. Was it too like what? According to the diagram, it seems RGR is B.
is the horizontal line?
Yes. Is the horizontal.
Yes.
Yes.
So it's a projection on the ground. So I okay.
This is perpendicular.
Satellite.
So here you have
range. Look angle. R, G, R, E, O is the hypotenuse. Okay.
No.
So
no.
Sin theta is R, R, over R.
Yeah.
Okay. Because, sorry, it's like a triangle, no? Rectangle triangle. I project this lens in this direction. We know the angle. This is a rectangular triangle. Yes? So if I want to know this distance, is given by the hypotenuse multiply the sin of this angle. The same for this little part. It's okay. Probably the figure are not enough clear. Sure, this figure are not clear. I'm quite sure.
This figure RZR is like
the
like
hypotenuse.
Like RZR is like a perpendicular.
This is perpendicular. The look angle is the angle between the vertical line to the looking direction. The line of sight is called the SAR. The line of sight. It means the direction where the pulse is going, is transmitted. With respect to the vertical line.
Mm-hmm. On the figure, sin theta is the opposite side of the theta, the horizontal line, over the hypotenuse. Sin theta is the opposite side, the horizontal.
Sin theta, yes.
It's the RGL, opposite side, mm-hmm. The angle over hypotenuse.
Mm-hmm.
Then, by, we get already the,
this is
the formula, it's right.
It's right?
Yeah.
No, you can, if you want, you can write.
Sin theta.
Sorry. Now we have to to see which is the minimum distance between point in the azimuth direction, because a satellite is also moving. So we have to distinguish, found the minimum distance between this point to be distinguished. For instance, these two points are in the same area and are not distinguished each other, are seem like are in the same pixel of the images. Okay, we have to introduce the wave, the length of the antenna, the physical length of the antenna, of the radio antenna, and this angle that we call beta. And we want to obtain this distance, the minimum distance, this length, that is the azimuth resolution. So the azimuth resolution is given by this angle multiplied the distance, the range distance. And this quantity, this angle, is given by the wavelength of the signal divided by the antenna length. And so we can introduce this in the formula. And also in this case, with some, I hope, correct geometric consideration, we can find a relationship between the azimuth resolution, the wavelength of the signal, the length of the antenna, the altitude of the satellite, and the look angle. And we see that for satellite, for instance, S1, the resolution in the azimuth was about 4.8 kilometer. So it's very huge azimuth resolution. It means that we cannot use to really to do measure, because we need a shorter resolution. Otherwise, it's like to have a pixel of 5 kilometers, more or less. So, from this consideration, what we can do to reduce this quantity? We can reduce the wavelength, not so all, and it's difficult to change this parameter to reduce the azimuth resolution. For instance, to have azimuth resolution of at least 100 meters, the length of the antenna, the physical length of the antenna, should be about 100 meters, but it's not possible to have this type of antenna. So, from the RAR, Real Aperture Radar, we move to SAR, Synthetic Aperture Radar. We understand that we can change this parameter, but we cannot produce a radar antenna with this real dimension. So we use a synthetic aperture, a synthetic antenna. It means that if this is your physical antenna, if you collect data for point 1 and point 2 using the antenna in the different position, we can suppose to use a synthetic antenna LS with this lens from point 1 to point 2. And in this position, the antenna is always looking at this target point Q. So, until this point is observed by the antenna in all these different position, we can collect together this different observation. Since to use a synthetic aperture, a synthetic antenna.
So it's like a combination of physical antenna, observation from the different physical antenna.
Yes, yes. So if you have, for instance, the point Q is visible from antenna in point A, antenna in point C, when you have this is the resolution, the azimuth of the radar we have seen before. It's given by the angle multiplied for the distance, for the range, and give us this solution. If we compute the same for a synthetic antenna, okay, when the point Q is visible from point A and point C, the maximum distance is given by twice this distance. So we have two times the radar azimuth resolution. And introduce this quantity here, we obtain that the resolution of the SAR in the azimuth direction is given by the length, the real length of the antenna, divided by 2. Okay, so it means that now in this formula we need a very big antenna, very long antenna. In the combining the observation, we obtain this relationship. It means that we need short antenna. We invert the problem. So using a synthetic antenna, the azimuth resolution is really depend on the wave, on the length of the antenna, and this antenna could be very short. So you can, this is from a geometrical point of view, to say, okay, the point Q have to be visible from point A to point C. And so it means that this is the position of the observation, of the observation. But we can repeat all this step using the Doppler effect, because the Doppler effect is at the base of this measure, because we have a relative movement between the satellite and the ground. So the frequency that the satellite receives from the ground has been under the Doppler effect, because there is this relative movement between the two sources. So at the beginning we can start to see the relative velocity between satellite and ground, and this relative velocity is given just a moment. Okay, the velocity in the R directional is given by the velocity projected in this direction. Okay. And if you introduce this part, we need this computation later. So if you write the Doppler frequency, the Doppler frequency is given by this relationship. Fs is the frequency of the signal sent by the satellite. F0 is the frequency that came back after the round trip. And do some mathematical step, we obtain that the frequency of the HECOS are equal more or less to this quantity, because the velocity of movement of the satellite is really less than velocity of the signal, the light velocity. So the differences between the actual frequencies emitted from the antenna and the frequency received is given by this information. So the Doppler frequency shift for the target is two times this frequency, because this values, because we have a round trip, the signal go and come back. So we have these two for this reason. Now, instead of this V velocity, we put the relationship that we have found before. And we obtain that the Doppler frequency is given by this relationship. So, we start from this, where we have x was the distance in the ground in the azimuth direction, if you remember in the figure x. That is the quantity that we want to estimate to have our resolution in the azimuth. And so we start from this relationship, we obtain this minimum distance that is related to the azimuth resolution. And okay, so the azimuth resolution is given by these differences of coordinates. And with the simple passes, we obtain okay, FD resolution of the Doppler frequency, T span time during which the point target was in the bin, in this inside this part. And we you attain because okay we express this Doppler resolution in terms of time, and the time is given is related of course to the velocity and to the geometry of the system, and we obtain that the azimuth resolution is given by the real antenna length over 2, as we have seen looking at the geometrical consideration. So I know probably you have to repeat all the steps, and just a moment. Okay. So is we are looking for this quantity. This is our x zero, and we want to see this quantity to obtain this quantity. Okay. So some consideration. In this formula we don't have any, it's not related to the range distance between satellite and the ground. And it's just related to, we don't have any, it's not depend on the frequency and on the look angle. It just depend on the length, or the actual length of the antenna, radio antenna that we use. Okay, so, sorry. So the signal collected by radar is transformed in SR images, and to do this, to collect images from the radar that have been taken in a different position, we can do different processing steps called focalization or co-registration. It means that we have to combine all these measures that the satellite have obtained in different positions to have just one images. Okay, we are not to see how you can do this because it's a very electronic quantity, but in a simple way we have to combine all this information to have your your images, your SAR images. Okay, this is an introduction of SAR. Now, have you got any question apart the problem before that I'm going to check why we have this problem? And but apart for this numerical problem that I'm going to check, you have problem is clear. We start from radar, the resolution in the azimuth for a radar system is too low, so we have to increase this resolution. It means that you have to reduce the minimum distance, the values. And to do this, we use synthetic aperture radar. We combine the different images coming, the different observation coming from different position of the satellite. In this way we reduce the azimuth resolution. Okay, and so we are going to see that we can do measure and we can obtain information for the ground, from of the ground.
It's again not too much reduce. Yeah?
Not too much?
Reduce, because if we have in the previous that real synthetic aperture, we have 100 meter resolution, and after all, from this synthetic aperture, this instrument, we have 100 by 2. Yeah, just half. So it's 15.
No, it depends on the wavelength. We have 100.
Yeah, we obtain 100 in that.
Yeah, okay. Is it. We have seen that for S1, we need in the range direction we have 25 meter of the resolution. We have done an exercise that real antenna length, no, to have a resolution of 100 meter, we need an antenna. 100, yes, 100 meter. We need a no, not 100. It was I don't remember it.
I remember 4.8 kilometers of
okay.
Resolution.
It is 200 meters, so it's inch. It's an inch.
Oh, yeah, yeah. Sorry, I confused.
Okay.
There's a lot of that in
this one. 100 meters. Okay, if you have a resolution of 100 meters, we need an antenna to build an antenna of this length, but it's not possible. So this is just to say, okay, we know that we have to use this type of wavelength to go through the ionosphere, so we cannot and to have enough energy, so we cannot change a lot of this parameter. The altitude, more or less, of the satellite is given by to see the ground and don't have effect in the orbit, too much orbit effect. And so this is was an example for this satellite, for instance. So we are going to see later that now the resolution is really better than these values. Okay, no, from this part. Okay, number from this part. Just a moment, I'm going to check. Okay. Yes. Okay. So, some information about these images. So the radar SAR is a looking is a call side looking. We have seen that the satellite don't send the signal along the vertical, but just along the range direction, along using a look angle. And okay, the SAR images, we have seen that is a complex. Images where we collect data, we put data about the intensity of the echo signal, but also of the phase. So we have seen that we have in our satellite in this direction, we send the signal collect data in this ground direction, and come back to the radar. And so on, and we collect this information to have a SAR images. So we have seen that the point black has been observed, and so on. So in this way, we can we have an image of the ground. Okay. This type of the focalization that collect data for each pixel seen in the ground. Okay, geometric distortion. We have a looking with a look side looking with a look angle. So we have some distortion. One is it's not easy to read the SAR images for a lot of things. One is also related, if you look at intensity if images you also that is a more easy images that you can see. You also it's not easy because you also have we have geometric distortion. For instance, there is the first shortening. It means if you look at this picture, that the distance between A and B is shorter in the plane of the images collected by our sensor. So this distance, this real distance between two points, could be shorter in the images. So the images are distorted, and this is called foreshortening. Or we can have a level of layover. Sorry, it means that in the plane of the images, the two points are shifted. For this special configuration with a very high slope of this short site, the signal coming from the point P arrive before the signal coming from the point A in the plane images. So the points are inverted and it's called layover. And we can also have a shadowing problem. Some point cannot be represented in the plane of the images because, for instance, this point is not reached by the radiation. So we can have part without information. This is the same thing that we collect all these type of disturbs, layover and shadow and so on. Okay, the same. Another important thing is that okay, we are going to see that we have a satellite that go around the Earth. And they observe in this direction, not just below. And we have two types of orbit. The orbit is the same, but we distinguish the observation coming from the satellite in ascending orbit and the satellite in descending orbit, when the satellite goes from south to north or when the satellite goes from north to south. What change? It changes the point of view, the how you see a zone. So probably if you have some shadowing in one direction for in one orbit, for instance ascending orbit, probably in the descending orbit you don't have this type of a problem and so on. So usually if you look at the paper on GPS, not GPS, SAR, you have two different results. They separate for the result for the ascending orbit and the result for the descending orbit. And at the end, the researcher try to combine the result. So it's really changed the point of view because you are looking in this oblique direction and the Earth is moving under. Yes?
You want those two directions? Which the satellite can be sent or they can be east to west?
No, because the orbit are in this direction and the Earth is rotating, but the orbit are not move from east to north. It's the Earth that is rotating. The orbit are in the same position, but it's the Earth that are rotating under. It's not for the GPS that we are using all the direction around the Earth. In this case, the satellite have its orbit in the planar orbit, like in the GPS. But in the GPS, we have different planar orbital plane, orbital plane. And in this case, it's just the Earth that is rotating under. It's like, do you understand? It's fixed the position. is fixed, no, it's on an orbit, but it's oriented now south north, not east, east west, east west. Sorry, today I'm tired. So, and this is about, yes.
The images, there is not the same direction.
Is the same direction?
Yeah, yeah, the same.
You have one sort of light, yeah, that comes same from east to west, and the other one that from the opposite side.
No, but it's right.
It's a Jovas one satellite.
Yeah, but
once
the orbit is the same.
When it goes, yes, the orbit is the same, but one
ascending or descending in both of the sphere.
Okay, because I move the satellite. Okay. The orbit, the satellite is go around the Earth, and the Earth is rotating under. Okay, so the orbit is the same, but in one case I see, for example, this is Italy, I see the signal when the satellite is going from south to north.
Okay.
When the satellite is go down, they look from north to south. It's in descending orbit.
Okay.
Okay, it's okay.
With these images, it seems that the satellite changed. It's ascending in the first part and descending and.
No.
I know how it works.
No, cioè, it's a, the satellite is moving around, and of course, when the satellite coming from you see the satellite coming from the south is in descending. When the orbit of the satellite is going down, you see the descended orbit. Is a images, a lot of these images from the TRE company, like this one. I don't put the credit, but it's also this one. It's from the material of this company that is was, sorry, this one. That is was a spin-off of my old university. They did a lot of work in SARA and was one of the most companies that started to show that we can use SARA for the physical application for monitoring and so on. Okay. It's okay for the orbit? No.
No.
The opposite direction. Okay. The radar is a coherent source of pulse. It means that during the measure, also the reflected signal doesn't change the phase over time. So the phase is a quantity that we can really measure. And we have seen that we measure phase and intensity that can be translated as a complex number, where A is the intensity of the images and phi is the phase images, or in term, the same in term of complex number I plus IQ.
Okay. But I and capital I and Q are now combined of phase and intensity. Is that true?
This is
like
chula from complex number and is the Cartesian form for complex number. Just take it like
this. No, capital A and phi are, capital A is for phase image and phi is for intensity image, yeah?
Yes.
Yes.
Capital A
is
A is okay. Intensity and phi is phase.
Phi is phase. And E power I phi is cos phi, sorry.
V is the real part.
So it's like cos phi plus I sine phi, and multiplying with A, it will be like the combined of I and Q are combined of phi phase and intensity both, I think.
So we see.
A is like
magnitude. The amplitude, yes, in the complex number is given by the this quantity, the module of this. But it's just to say why we need a complex number to represent our measure, because we want to collect, we have images, because we have seen that we have this relative movement, but we collect two quantities and we have to take into account for these two quantities. So it's easy to use complex numbers. So it was used just to say it's easy use a complex number to take information about intensity and phase.
Okay.
So this is an example from University of Leeds, Tim Wright and other researchers do a lot of work on SAR. And this is, for instance, the two information that we can obtain, an amplitude and images of the amplitude and images of the phase. You can see that the face, the images of the face is a very strange images. It's like random noise, because the face we have seen in the GPS is a periodic number. It's a number between minus pi plus pi. So it's repeating itself. And when we represent these values, it look like a salt and pepper images is called, with a really random images. For the now we see the intensity of images that can be with the A in the previous representation or in the set. So this is the definition. And this was an images of the Vesuvius, is a volcanoes, Italian volcanoes near to Naples. And you can say that it look like a photographic images of the of you see the volcanoes, the Naples Bay and so on. But you know that we have a lot of distortion, geometric distortion, so it's not so easy sometimes to read this type of picture. And you see that in some part we have a very white, very brilliant signal. This is the part covered by the city, by the buildings. For instance, the volcanoes is covered by vegetation, but, and so is dark. So it means that when you have a white signal, it means that you have a high backscattering signal. When you have black images, it means that you have a lower signal from the ground. And here we have the sea that is really dark. Okay. Just one slide and we have the break. So, using intensity images, we don't have geometric information. It means that the two points A and B that are in our resolution bin have a different height, but they will be collected in the same pixel. So we lose any information about the geometry, about the height of these two points. So for this reason, it's important to look at the phase images. Even if the phase images we have seen is really complicated to understand, because if you look, we started from this type of images. Okay, now we have a break. I'm going to check the problem of before and